V.K. Ahuja, Associate Professor of Law at University of Delhi. Our Head of the Department, Professor Dr. Pallavi Gupta Ma'am and Professor A.K. Tyagi Sir.
Presentation, which was a part of my course when I was in Cardiff University, UK. So we were there for a program on law teaching and legal research skills. So this was one of the modules, and I thought that this is something, you know, which all of us require. In fact, I was also a teacher at that point of time, and it was in 2004. That means that I had teaching experience of more than 10 years at that point of time. But still, I found this particular exercise to be very useful. So I thought that let me just share that with you, share my experiences with you. So this is not exactly what we were taught. So I modified that as per our own conditions. So maybe that we will find it a little helpful in your teaching also. My lecture, in fact, when I just talked to Pallavi ji, there were three things that I wanted to speak on. One was how to prepare a lecture. Second component of this presentation is how to deliver it. So the preparation and the delivery are the two different things and the most important things. And then I thought that if the time permits, you know, that I'll speak something on research ethics also. And the room was as big as a theater hall, must be having a capacity of 300 students, and it was, you know, there was a podium and there was a touch screen was there. On one side there was OHP projector which was there. So the first day a lady professor was there. She delivered a lecture, and it was really wonderful. What she did, she started with some slides, and the slides, you know, which she has prepared, that was having some cuttings from the newspaper. So when you read the newspaper, every day you have some kind of you know, news which are legal news. So she had taken some clips from there, some headlines which were there on the slide, and she started from there. And it has relied on the English judgment. So English judgments are not applicable in its entirety in the Indian scenario, because the literacy rate is not as high as in the UK. After criticizing the earlier judgment, he himself said that now we are going to rely on American judgments. I was wondering, you know, if the English judgments are not applicable in its entirety, how can the American judgments be applicable? So he gave his judgment while relying on the American judgment. So, you know, sometimes when you read the judgment, when you apply your mind to that, you will definitely come across where the things have gone wrong or where the things could have been little better. So this is the approach which you are supposed to take while making a critical analysis of the judgments and the legislation. If you find the legislative drafting problems are there, you can, you know, tell them that, well, these are the provisions where there may be some interpretation, you know, which may be given in a different manner. So ultimately what happens is that you can make a critical analysis, not only of the judgments, but also of the legislations also. And thereafter you are also writing an outline, you are giving an outline of the lecture also. What does it mean? That, well, I am going to, like, if suppose I have to teach the sources of international law, so I can really tell them what exactly I am going to discuss today. Now the student is clear in mind, this is the topic, these are the things which are to be discussed in the class. Now the moment he is clear, you know, there is every probability that he is going to understand your lecture in much better manner, and he is going to be attentive in the classroom.